الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Dear brothers and sisters, boys and girls, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله سبحانه وتعالى says in the Quran, in Surah Hujurat, ayah number 11, O you who believe, let not one group of people make fun of another. Perhaps the ones being made fun of are better than them. And do not let women make fun of another woman. Perhaps the woman being made fun of is better than them. And do not insult one another. Do not call each other by offensive nicknames. Evil is the name or mention of disobedience after one's faith. And whoever does not repent, then it is those who are the zalimun, the wrongdoers and oppressors. So we understand from this ayah that it's haram to bully others and make fun of them. And it will result in punishment from Allah. Perhaps the one that is being made fun of is more beloved to Allah. Let us remember this when we ever try to make fun of someone. Perhaps Allah loves them and does not love us. Didn't the mushrikeen, the disbelievers, make fun of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And we know Allah loved him and did not love them. Didn't the munafiqeen, the hypocrites, make fun of the sahaba? And we know Allah loved the sahaba and not them. Imam al-Bayhaqi narrates in Shu'bah al-Iman that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Verily, those people that make fun of people, for them a gate of Jannah will be opened. It will be said to them, come and enter. That person will come with all the anguish and depression. But when he gets close, the gate will be closed in his face. Then another gate to Jannah will be opened. And it will be said, come and enter. So that the person comes with all his anguish and depression. But when he gets close, the gate will close on his face. This will keep on happening to him until he gets to the point where it will be said to him, come and enter. And he will not come from the despair of ever entering paradise." Here's another hadith. Al-Ma'mur ibn Saud narrates that he once saw Abu Dharr radiallahu anhu wearing a beautiful shirt. His slave standing next to him was wearing a shirt exactly like it, warm and beautiful. Ma'mur said to Abu Dharr, "Perhaps you could take the shirt off your servant and give him another less expensive one." "Never," said Abu Dharr. "For once I had a servant whose mother was not an Arab, and I cast him and his mother. That servant went to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, complaining of the words I had said. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw me, he commented, 'Oh Abu Dharr, you are a man who still has jahiliyyah, pre-Islamic ignorance in him.' Because of these painful words, Abu Dharr, may Allah be pleased with him, would always dress his servants in the exact same garments that he would wear. So don't bully anyone and try to help others getting bullied. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.